الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونشكره ونتوب إليه من جميع الذنوب والخطايا ونستغفره. سبحانه يقبل توبة التائبين ويتوب على عباده العاصين، فيفتح لهم أبواب التوبة في كل وقت وزمان. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، مالك الملك وملك الملوك، قلوب الملوك بين يديه سبحانه وتعالى يقلبها كيف يشاء. فاللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك، واللهم يا مصرف القلوب والأبصار صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك، أحينا حياة السعداء، حياة من تحب بقاءه، وتوفنا وفاة السعداء، وفاة من تحب لقاءه. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله الصادق الأمين وخاتم النبيين وخيرة الخلق أجمعين، بعثه ربه ليخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور، فأدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله سبحانه وتعالى به الغمة، فاللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك عليه يا أرحم الراحمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. الله سبحانه وتعالى سن الهجرة من الكفر إلى الإيمان، فهاجر النبيون قبل محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وهاجر الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم، وهاجر أصحابه. فالهجرة إخوتي وأخواتي هي هجر مكان إلى مكان، أو هجر خلق إلى خلق. وحينما يأتي شهر المحرم، واليوم هو آخر أيام هذا الشهر الحرام، شهر الله المحرم، نتذكر دائماً هجرة الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم، وهي قصة الإسلام التي نكررها كل عام، فنأخذ منها دروساً وعبراً حتى نعيش على هديه عليه الصلاة والسلام. هاجر النبيون قبل محمد، فهاجر نوح عليه السلام حينما كذبوه قومه وآذوه، فبنى السفينة ونجاه الله سبحانه وتعالى ومن معه من المؤمنين. هاجر إبراهيم عليه السلام بعد أن عرض الدعوة على أبيه وقومه، فرفضوا أن يعبدوا الله وفضلوا عبادة المخلوق على عبادة الخالق سبحانه وتعالى، فآمن له لوط وقال إني مهاجر إلى ربي. هاجر إبراهيم عليه السلام، وهاجر لوط عليه السلام، وأمره الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يترك قريته ومن معه من المؤمنين، فأسر بأهلك بقطع من الليل واتبع أدبارهم ولا يلتفت منكم أحد وامضوا حيث تؤمرون. وهاجر موسى عليه السلام من فرعون وطغيانه ببني إسرائيل إلى سيناء، وهاجر سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم من مكة بلده وموطنه والمكان الذي نشأ فيه إلى المدينة المنورة، حيث كان اسمها يثرب، فلما انتقل إليها سميت المدينة فنورت بنور النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. الله سبحانه وتعالى, each and every year we remember the hijrah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the hijrah is not just a story that we tell and we retell. The hijrah is a life story of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, leaving the land of kufr, disobedience, oppression, to the land of iman, Islam, and enlightenment. The hijrah is a concept that if we apply it in the linguistic meaning, it means leaving one thing to another, or one place to another, or one characteristic to another. We all are immigrants. We are all muhajirs. And sometimes we left our lands and we came here. Some of us, they have plans for a better life. And some of us were escaping from oppression. And some of us were looking for a place in which they can practice their faith freely. And this is hijrah. But the difference of our hijrah and hijrah to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions, that the hijrah of the Prophet and the prophets before him, it was for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake, and this is the most noble hijrah of all. To leave everything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nuh alayhi salam did it. Ibrahim alayhi salam did it. Lut alayhi salam did it. Musa alayhi salam did it. And many other messengers. And it ended with our beloved messenger Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doing hijrah from his hometown of Mecca to the city of Yathrib that was called after his hijrah Al-Madinatul Munawwara. So brothers and sisters, the concept of hijrah in Islam, if we remember the story of Islam each and every year in the month of Al-Muharram with the coming of the new Islamic calendar, and we do not get the lessons from that hijrah, we are just telling a story, and we may not change. But if we look closely to the incidents of hijrat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and focus on each and every situation, then we will learn that the best hijrah is hijrah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all of us now, right here, we can be among the muhajireen. So hijrah, in the general sense, everybody falls under that. But we are looking for the hijrah in the particular sense, the most noble hijrah, hijrat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why did the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim leave Mecca first to Al-Habasha, and second to Al-Habasha again, and then third to Al-Madinah, and before that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left to Al-Ta'if? Were they looking for a better place to make money, as sometimes we do? Were they looking for better jobs? Were they looking for a place for their family members to live in a luxury and they do not worry about anything as most of us do? They were looking for a place to stay safe. That's why the first hijrah in Islam, al-hijrah ila al-Habasha, كما قال علماء الإسلام كانت الهجرة إلى الحبشة والحبشة يومئذ هي دار أمان حيث كان بها ملك عادل لا يظلم عنده أحد فأمر النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أصحابه بالهجرة إلى هناك حتى يأمنوا على أنفسهم وأهليهم ودينهم فالحبشة دار أمان ولكن المدينة كانت دار إيمان. وهناك فرق كبير بين هجرة الأمن وهجرة الإيمان. إنسان لا يأمن على نفسه في بلده فيهاجر لبلد آخر، ولكن إنسان يهاجر بدينه بغرض الدعوة إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى فنعم بها من هجرة. So the first هجرة والحبشة was from the land of Mecca. Instability, oppression, troubles and difficulties to the land of Habasha, security and safety. And later from Mecca to Medina, it was from the land of Mecca, again oppression and travel difficulties to the land of Iman, belief, the land of Yathrib, Medina. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, رأيت في المنام أني أهاجر إلى أرض بها نخل فذهب وهلي أي ظني إلى أنها اليمامة أو هجر فكانت المدينة أو يثرب. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I have seen in my dreams that I am going to go for hijra to a land that has lots of palm trees. So I was thinking it will be اليمامة or هجر, but it is Yathrib al-Madina. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to us in the Quran that this type of hijrah from the land of oppression, when you are oppressed because of your faith, because you cannot practice your Islam freely, you have to leave and go. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ أَرْضِي وَاسِعَةً فَإِيَّايَ فَاعْبُدُونَ. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ أَرْضِي وَاسِعَةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Oh my servants, those who believed, my land is big and wide, so you can leave. And also those, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains to us that some of us will stay in the land of oppression, the land of difficulties, and they do not leave it, and they take it as an excuse for not fulfilling their obligations, the rights of Islam, and they say, we cannot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that this will be difficult because we have to leave and move on with our deen, with our faith, wherever it is possible to practice. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ ظَالِمِي أَنفُسِهِمْ قَالُوا فِي مَا كُنْتُمْ قَالُوا كُنَّا مُسْتَضْعَفِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ قَالُوا أَلَمْ تَكُنْ أَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَةً فَتُهَاجِرُوا فِيهَا. Those when the angels come to take their souls and they wrong themselves and they ask them, why did you do that? They said, we were oppressed in this land. The angels will say to them, wasn't the land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala big and wide for you to go and make hijrah? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help and assist in that. So brothers and sisters, the concept of hijrah and the story of hijrah is a very good story. We will just need to take one single lesson from that hijrah in today. And how to relate that lesson to our presence, our present time. Who was the first Sahabi to do hijrah to Al-Madina? We knew that hijrah to Al-Habasha happened before. There was one Sahabi that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent to Al-Madina after he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made Bay'atul Aqabatil Ula, the first pledge of allegiance in Aqaba. The people in Yathrib asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for someone to teach them the Quran and to teach them the legislation of Islam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chose someone who was unique to fulfill that mission, someone that his name is still memorable, someone who accepted Islam although he was very rich and he was living his life like a king, but he accepted Islam in the early stages, in the first couple of years in Mecca. And this Sahabi is Mus'ab ibn Umair radiyallahu anhu, the first messenger of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Al-Madina is Mus'ab ibn Umair radiyallahu anhu. The first convoy, the first one who started reciting the Quran in Al-Madinah, Mus'ab ibn Umayr. Along with him was Abdullah ibn Maktoum, the blind Sahabi. And Mus'ab, the ulama said, he was the first Muslim to pray Jum'ah in Al-Madinah. The first Jum'ah ever was performed was led by Sayyidina Mus'ab ibn Umayr radiallahu anhu. And he used to go from one house to another house to convey the message of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Who is Mus'ab ibn Umayr first to relate to our present time? Mus'ab was a very young man. When he accepted Islam, he was in the last years of his 20s, coming to his 30s. He comes from a very rich family from Quraysh, the same tribe of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His father and mother used to buy for him his clothes and the perfumes from different places. At that time, the most expensive perfume and the most expensive clothes came from Mus'ab radiallahu anhu. He will be known in the city of Mecca from his perfume radiallahu anhu. When he walks in the street, people will know that Mus'ab was there. But when he knew that there is a new Prophet coming and he is teaching the people in the house of Al-Arqam, he went there, he listened to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he accepted Islam, and he was hiding his Islam until someone told on him, and his mother was very tough with him. She put him inside the house. He couldn't leave, and she put him and she tied him up, and she was very hard on him. And she commanded him to leave Islam, but he didn't, radiallahu anhu. And he flee from his house to Al-Habasha with the first group of Muslims who made the first hijrah in Islam, radiallahu anhu arda. Then he comes back, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sends him to Al-Madinah. And Mus'ab will go and call for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and will make it short. The first year in Ghazwat Badr, he was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The third year of Hijrah in Ghazwat Uhud, Mus'ab ibn Umayr radiallahu anhu was the one in charge of the flag of the battle. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam handed him the flag of the battle, and he radiallahu anhu was fighting, and he was attacked in his right hand. It was cut, and he took the flag with his left hand, and he was attacked, and his left hand was cut, and he took the flag by his arms, and he was attacked until he died, radiallahu anhu, in the battle of Uhud. After the battle is over, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks for the martyrs, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks at Mus'ab and cries, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he says, this is Mus'ab ibn Umayr. They could not find a piece of clothes to cover his body for his janazah. And Mus'ab used to be the most rich in Mecca. He used to change clothes every single day, every couple of hours. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam looks at him and cries, and he says, this is Mus'ab. I have seen him in Mecca when he was wearing the best clothes, having the best smell. And now we cannot even find a kafan for him. When they put the sheet of clothes on his face, his feet will be exposed. If they pull it down, his face will be exposed, radiallahu anhu. And he was about 40 years of age when he died. What did Mus'ab do, brothers and sisters? A young man living in luxury, he left everything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He educated himself. He stand next to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He left the influence, he left richness, and he preferred to be under the feet of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be a servant to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he became one of the stars of Islam, that when we mention his name, we say radiallahu anhu. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he saw Mus'ab in the battle of Uhud, when he was a shaheed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayah, من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر وما بدلوا تبديلا. among the believers are men who have been true to the covenant they have given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they fulfilled it to the extreme. And some of them are waiting and they never changed the promise they have given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the young man, brothers and sisters. Where are our young Muslims nowadays? What do they think of? They think of material stuff. They never think about doing something for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mus'ab left everything for Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the shahada and gave him Jannah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with him, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is pleased with him, and all Muslims are pleased with him, and he will be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in al-Jannah. Where are we, brothers and sisters, from that young man who left everything for da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Did we leave something for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And this is the real hijrah. Did we leave something evil to something good? Did we leave something suspicious, not completely halal, to something halal, although it is less? Did we leave something from this dunya looking for Jannatullah and Rahmatullah and Maghfiratullah? When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam akhbarana أننا إذا تركنا شيئا لله أبدلنا الله سبحانه وتعالى خيرا منه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "You will never leave something for Allah سبحانه وتعالى except He سبحانه وتعالى will give you better than what you left in dunya, and He سبحانه وتعالى is going to reward you with Jannah in the day of يوم القيامة." أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وحبيبه وبعد. Brothers and sisters, hijra is to leave something for something, and it should be leaving something for something better. But sometimes we leave something for something lower, something good for something bad and worse. And we do not take the lesson from the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim lives, who gave us the best of examples ever. And we can see this in our community. And we're talking about Mus'ab ibn Umair and the youth and the Muslims who have been married, and the couples who have troubles in their marriages. And some of them, those who have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they come to the masjid and they ask for counseling. Some others go directly to the court and they fight each other and they forget about Islam. They just look for dunya and the materialistic gain they are looking for. And we have too many cases, brothers and sisters, in our community when some brothers abuse the rights that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to them, and they do not even know the value of marriage and the value of family. And they break that bond that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made sacred for very small reasons. On the other side, we have some sisters who are looking for the Canadian divorce to get half of what the man owns. And they would like to go to the court and stand in front of the judge, and they don't care about things except what they are going to collect from that man. It is all about me, myself, and I. And they forget about the court of justice when they stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yawm al-qiyamah, and Allah will ask them about this. You take this in dunya, you have nothing today. We have these two extremes, brothers and sisters. Some brothers take it to the extreme, and some sisters take it to the extreme, and the children are in the middle, suffering between both spouses and losing their identity when they see the parents fighting here and there. We cannot expect a generation of Islam that will carry the banner of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah without preparing them spiritually and psychologically. We damage our children's psychology by whatever we are doing in our houses. We fight so hard for the money and the wealth, and we forget that we are Muslims. We only come to the masajid that we know the imam of that masjid will give me more. But those who will say the truth, we will never go to them. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not giving us the victory that we are looking for? Because we are not making him subhanahu wa ta'ala victorious in our lives. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu in tansurullaha yansurkum wa yuthabbit aqdamakum. Brothers and sisters, Hijrat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam means we have to leave these evil characteristics that we have. We have to look into our family members, our kids. We are losing them. Wallahi, we are losing our generation. The young Muslims are confused. They are in the middle of nowhere, seeing all these pressures from outside, and then they come into the separation and divorce and khul'a and fasch and fights inside the family. Then they get lost and they have no Muslim identity whatsoever. And they are silent. We do not hear them because we do not see them. We live our lives the way we want it, and we refer that way to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we do not go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we see a brother dies in front of us, when we see a sister in a coma or in a hospital and she's asking for dua, when we lose a family member, when we lose a dear friend, and we are the same, and we never change, and we go for salah, and we give zakah, and we fast Ramadan, and we go for hajj and make many umrahs. Our deen is not all about salah and ibadat, brothers and sisters. More than half of this religion is about dealings with each other, akhlaq. And the first to start, it has to start at home. If you don't have it, you will never be able to pass it to the next generation. If you don't have the love to that deen, to that sharia, to that way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will never be able to teach it to the next generation. Even if you hide your differences and you don't show them the face that they should see, they will never take from you. Brothers and sisters, the community is in great troubles. Look around you and you will know it. And as an imam, I see some things that no one else can see. And I hear stories that no one else can hear. And I see things that out loud, haram, 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 major sins. And people are doing it. And they come after the time is over and they try to cry, and there is no way out of it. So please, brothers and sisters, wake up. This is the time when we renew our covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every year in Al-Muharram. When we think about hijrah, make hijrah from that quality of being selfish and help each other. Make hijrah from that evil mindset that you want to own stuff. Just me, myself, and I. Just make hijrah from these things before the angel of death comes to your door and you will say, can you give me some time to repent? And there is no way that we can wait. We have to answer the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And today, a sister who is one of the dearest sisters in the Muslim community in Ottawa just passed away. And her janazah was in the cemetery just before Jum'ah. Sister Khadija Hafaji, she's one of the leaders in this community. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give her maghfirah and rahmah. Allahumma ghafir laha warhamha wa samihha wa'afu anha. Allahumma akrim nuzulaha wa wassi' mudkhalaha. Allahumma ghasilha bil ma'i wa thalj wal barad wa naqqiha min al-dhunub wal khataya kama yunqqa al-thawb al-abyad min al-danas. Allahumma adkhilha al-jannah اللهم أدخلها الجنة، اللهم أدخلها الجنة، اللهم باعدها عن النار، اللهم باعدها عن النار، اللهم باعدها عن النار. اللهم إنا قد سامحناها فيما بيننا وبينها، فسامحها أنت فيما بينك وبينها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احشرها مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين، وحسن أولئك رفيقا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا، اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت على الحق أقدامنا. اللهم انصرنا على القوم الكافرين، اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، اللهم اجعلنا من الذين هجروا المعاصي للطاعات، واجعلنا من الذين هجروا كل شيء خبيث إلى أحسن الأخلاق. اللهم وفقنا حتى نكون من الذين رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أجل وأكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقموا الصلاة.